Hi, my name is Morgan Delarue, and I want to tell you about why cells can be under pressure and how it might affect them. Any cell can be under pressure, but here I will talk about cancer cells. Cells divide in our body all the time. For instance, in the lower part of the gut, the colon, cells are born and die so quickly that almost all cells are renewed every day. The colon that you have today is different from the colon that you had yesterday. In the colon, this cell renewal happens at the bottom of small structures called crypts. When cells divide normally, the new cells move towards the tip of the crypts. Before a cell can divide, it has to copy its genetic material, the DNA, and give one copy to each new cell. Sometimes a mistake is made when the DNA is copied. This error is called a mutation. Some mutations cause cells to divide too quickly. This is how tumors begin, with mutant cells dividing faster than normal cells. As time goes on, the tumor grows more and more and starts to push against the surrounding cells. This is how tumors create mechanical pressure. People have thought a lot about how tumor cells talk to normal cells in terms of chemical signals. However, we know very little about how the mechanical forces created by too much cell division in a small space affect the cells. This is the question that my research will tackle. How might cells respond to mechanical pressure? How does squishing a cell change the way that it behaves? Before dividing, a cell needs to grow. For instance, mechanical pressure could affect cell growth as it is more difficult to grow and then divide under pressure. Mechanical pressure could also cause cells to move out of a tumor and invade distant organs. This invasion of surrounding tissues by tumor cells is called metastasis and is one of the most dangerous aspects of cancer. If you wish to learn more about the details of how pressure can affect the motion of molecules in cells, please watch Greg's video.